box into place. Power surge shorts out the storage areas.
Was I muted? Oops.
voice echoes through the fountain. This complex will sound in 5 minutes, please. Self-destruct. Self-destruct.
That's a pretty good run.
Haywire gestures to the glowing. Take it.
So I hit 27. We still have a couple quests left. Maybe. I have at least 1-3 left that I want to do. Since this is a really good party. So I'm going to do that. And then maybe switch to my rogue. We'll see. back on this character, we're gonna have to spend the first minute buffing. Definitely a much harder way to get votes. Doggy. I just realized I didn't need my roll this morning because the game was down. Get the heck back here. Okay. Been killed by that several times. Tend to be cautious around it.
Stand amidst a scene of terrible slaughter. The inevitable has already passed this way. Enjoyable. It goes this smoothly, this difficult level. Yeah.
good place to rest.
Entered a new section of the caves. In the distance, you have never heard of a beholder serving a drow or anyone else. You shudder to imagine the bargain that they must have struck. Giant mushrooms grow more sparse as you emerge from the beholder's domain. Ahead, currents of water plunge into a clearing far below. You leap into the waterfall, where there's no turning back. Water in the air.
I might as well go ahead and do Whiz King.
This impressive structure houses the tomb of the Wizard King.
Is stream and everything going okay still? Looks like it is. Fails on cupcakes must be tier. this. I kind of want to do work turn two. I may stick you with it.
Careful fingers, you take the ancient scrolls and place them into your pack. This impressive structure houses the tomb of the Wizard King.
Fate Spinner first. There was other ones I could take. Let's just take. Oh, Griffin. Sorry, I'm being damage reduction. No, let's take it, damage reduction. Yeah. Get out of all that. That's ridiculous. One mom and I'm married.
The life. The tunnels run deep beneath the Tree of Woe. Moaning lost souls call out to you. Several philosophers mull curiously. The wayward philosopher. A thin layer of cracked ice covers the hole. You're descending deeper into the glacial abyss. A voice calls to you. The abbot has called something else. Free me. I can help you. Soulbound brothers appear above and below. This is our chance to be together again, brother.
Welcome back.
God is slain, but cannot pass on without his brother. You freed the soulbound brothers, sending them to the afterlife.
Go ahead and type your questions. We'll see what we can do about answering them. I don't believe so.
The familiar voice calls again, louder and clearer.
But I defer to somebody else on that one.
Is a dreadful atmosphere.
That's what I thought.
Free me from this prison, and I will aid you.
I thought it was only one combat stance at a time.
Most trusted advisors were in case of this. Of the frozen conservators are bound to the magical cage that imprisons the
I think it depends on what you want to build. I'm not sure about the Paladin synergy. Two up and fighting high saves and you see. Obviously, you probably want to take your weapon specialization line. Let's see, so that enables the Kensai abilities. I'm not too familiar with the Paladin trees. Other than I know, Stalwart Defender's in there. There's some other stuff that's interesting. That seems pretty nice. Once again, scales of surety as the scale metal armor. Yeah, I don't want that at the moment. I think I might have one of those. I'll just go over to Flashmaker. Welcome, Vetachetta. How's it going? Let's see, we're going to Fleshmaker. I can show you my Kensai tree if you're interested in what I spent my stuff on. So, Kensai's on the left here. It's the second from the left. Mobbed. I do find the ladder first. Kind of hard to do in the middle of a quest, so hold on. I'll get back up there. So, let's see, back here. Alright, there you go. Oh, is there somewhere I can put it where it's not quite in my way so bad? Hold on a second. Let's see if I can... There we go. Move it up over there. So I at least see a little bit here at the bottom. So you can look up the abilities on your own screen, but I've got those first four of the cores, and then I went the weapon specialization all the way up.
A closed door seals off the drop shaft to the chopping room. You land with a splash. The stream carries fresh zombies.
And the extra tactical abilities, and the... I needed this, what's it called up here? One with the blade. Because it works with the monk abilities, so I needed that. So that's why I went up both sides there to get that, and then the strength. I don't use the extra action moves. I feel the DCs are worth it because I don't land enough on the higher difficulties. I can trip sometimes on hard and never on elite. So everything. Every little bit helps, and trip is so useful. Stunning blow can be useful too, but trip in particular is really useful. I don't like thunder. I know a lot of people recommend extra action boosts, so it just depends on what you use. I took everything that's plus hit, plus damage, plus critical. I took all that stuff. I use power surge all the time. I use attack speed boost all the time. I use shattering strike all the time. I use troop a lot.
Lost in thought, Mentau's bride is busy at work in the control room.
Yes, I believe that's the case. Shattering Strike is very useful, I use it all the time. If nothing else, it's that extra plus one attack. Shattering effect's kind of a bonus of it, but it's really useful just to have another powerful attack. That's a good advice, Skunk. Yeah, remember you can always pay some plat and reset stuff, so try it if you can find something you like. Great, if not, it's okay. You can switch it out. Try again.
And a large static charge fills the air. The lightning machine is open.
The lightning machine shuts down. The true source of the machine's disruption appears. The laboratory is safe once more.
So we're waiting for somebody to open the chest, or reconnect before opening the chest again. So yeah, you have to get Shattering Strike and then Deadly Strike to get one with the blade. You also have to get this Keen Edge and all the weapon specializations. So it is a pretty significant advancement to get there. And really, it's only good for Monk or Grandmaster Flowers. So you can be centered. Every time I have a green card, I do things slightly differently, just to see how everything goes. I used to get all three levels of this, but I don't like weapon meditation at all, so I don't get it anymore because of that. I don't like wasting points there. That's four extra points right there to get that. I started branching out into Harper Agent instead. Getting some of these things over here. Basically, you get like two charges of it or something, and you have to just, before combat, sit there and let it meditate, and then you get the stacks on your weapon. It's good, like between waves of Devil Assault or at the last shrine before the boss kind of thing. I didn't like because you had to stop and let it happen. I don't remember how long it lasts, 20, 40 something seconds, I don't know. And you get those stacks that, yeah, okay, it's plus one, but it's not that great. Deadly Strike, I don't think I use that one. Yeah, I don't use it. I don't use it because I don't have any action boosts to use on it. I'll answer that in a second here. Let me look, see what I got. Junk. Somebody got Mentos goggles, which I want. There's a lot of abilities in Grandmaster Flowers that work well centered, but I don't think it grants evasion. I'm not sure.
A hoarse voice drifts through the halls.
Seek the flame, guardians. Defeat them all. Then I shall appear.
This portal glows with an infernal heat. Four torches, this wall is curiously devoid of flame.
Torches call out for flame,
says the A flame flares to life, bringing the guardian with it. Says the voice.
On the inferno. Extinguish the torches to summon him again.
As the last torch goes out, the undead flame guardian appears.
When the torches burn, the guardian will appear.
The guardian roars to life, summoned by the torches.
Seek out the undead guardian in the inferno.
The western exit from this chamber has collapsed into rubble. A passage to the west leads out of this infernal chamber.
When the torches are dark, the guardian will arrive.
As the torches darken, a strange chill fills the room. The undead flame guardian has returned. Large braziers are arranged around the edge of this massive central chamber.
Torches still burn, the voice says.
Sinus appears in answer to your summons.
I cannot help you. The Cinder Spirit says, I must destroy you. She has commanded it.
Yeah. mention of the Black Abbot. Perhaps someone else controlled the creature? Passage to the catacombs opens. Lost in prayer, the high priestess kneels before the altar. Long have we waited, says the voice. Now our time has come. A voice whispers in your ear, "Be gone, unless you wish to see the plane of death." Dolor fades, and you are returned to Eberron. You have found a quiet place to rest in the depths of the ruined temple. The last offering explodes in a shower. The blood is the life.
You know what? I was talking to you and you didn't hear me. Because I was muted. Good call. Before I start doing more of this. Alright. So here's what I got. I got the Epic Glimpse of the Soul. Witch Wisdom plus 11 for the saves. True Seeing, of course, is always nice. Intercession Ward is awesome. Illusion Enhancement Enchantment Saves is also nice on that. What? You take a picture of that. That's hilarious. The Epic Munos Legends, obviously, Fortification, Vitality, Fortitude Save, Sheltering, plus it's part of the Unbreakable Adamancy set. Now, all this stuff is upgradable with augment slots. I just haven't done it yet. I'm still wearing this because of Death Block and negative energy absorption, of course, and then protection from evil is also useful. Trinket slots are widely debated. I like this because I have it at level 20, so I wear it from 20 to 28. Search, spot, insightful intelligence is nice. True Seeing, of course, and then the awesome thing is the Master's Gift, which is the same thing as your Voice of the Master, only as an augment. Epic Cloak of Ice. It's got fire resistance, fire shield, cold, which is awesome. Freezing ice is the big thing. So when people miss you, let's see, no, when you make attacks, yeah, it occasionally freezes people, which is awesome. Epic Belt of Thought for Remembrance, Death Block, Constitution, Concentration, Resistance, Dodge, and Regeneration. So really it's Death Block, Constitution, Resistance, and Dodge, and then Regeneration. Okay, you know, it's not as useful as the rest of it, but it's really good. We got the Epic Eye of the Beholder, which absorbs Doomsphere spells, Intelligence, Wizardry, and Spell Save. Iron Mitt, I have this for the Healing Amplification. That's really the only thing I have it for. It's just too good to have a higher healing amp. It helps a whole lot. I have been wearing the Orcish Privateer's boots. I like these because of freedom of movement. That's the big thing on them. However, you have the option of the Epic Boots of the Innocent, which are nice because they have the resistance, speed, the plus 12 to your trip and improved trip, plus 12 to the Stunning Blow and Stunning Fist, plus 12 to Sunder and Improved Sunder, plus you have Greater Heroism, which is plus 4 to attack, roll, saving throws, and skill checks. I mean, that's hard to beat as well. You have the Epic Ring of Unknown Origins, which is kind of like the old Green Steel protection from everything. You got Immunity Fear, Blindness Immunity, Whirlwind Ward, and Proof Against Disease and Poison. The Epic Ethereal Bracers are awesome. Dex 11, Repost 9, Ghostly, Deadly, Speed, Feather Falling. It's another handy all-around item. And then the Epic Death's Rampart, which is heavy armor. The Night Shield Clicky is awesome for resisting magic missiles. You've got Elemental Resistances, 30 plus an additional 10, so it's 40 to all your elemental resistances, which is nice. And then you've got your insightful saves, and it's part of the Unbreakable Adamacy, so plus 5 PR and R. So all told, that adds up to my PRR is 56.52% less damage from bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing attacks. And I've got 42.53 less damage from acid, sonic, fire, electric, cold, alignment, light, positive, negative, poison, and rust attacks. So that's your PRR and MRR, and then you've got your saves. In addition to that, I've got an 80 fire resistance. I mean, then your saves get bumped up. Saves aren't great, but they work. So yeah, all told, that's a pretty good set that's easy to get. The Orcish Privateer's boots and the Iron Mitts come from Three Pearl Cove. All the rest of this stuff here comes from Epic Orchard. This, of course, is from Necropolis. And then you've got this from the Crystal Cove. And then you've got the weapon, which is Thunderforged, which comes from Thunderhome. So that's a quick overview of Epic. Yeah, I know. I forgot to do my daily. Well, I didn't do my daily list. I usually do it first thing in the morning, and because the game was down, I didn't. I want to go to another character before I roll it, though. I usually do roll on a different character. So, yeah, and quick overview. That's how all that works for Epic level gear. Now let me look at that URL you posted. Let's see. Open it up over here. Oh, good, I can't zoom in. Yeah, as far as Kensai goes, it looks awesome. I obviously don't have a paladin, so I can't tell you about the paladin trees, but as far as the Kensai goes, that's a good way to do a lot more damage. Yeah, the reflex saves are awesome. So I'd say, yeah, it's a good selection. Stuff you get is BT. Oh, yeah, that's true as well. So I might pass some of this stuff off to my sorcerer for more. Can you remove a taint of evil on the epic locus of Vol? Because I would kind of like to wear that too. Oh well. So anyway, thanks for your input there. How are you supposed to say this? Cube? 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 I am going to take a break now. Let me put myself promo up here real quick. Just so we have a little bit of that embedded in the stream. Other places to contact me and follow me and such. And then I'll put my break sign up. And mute myself. And I will be back in a little bit. Yeah. Thanks, Stack Mechanic, for stopping by and asking questions. It's always nice to have something to talk about and get people help. And, of course, Skunk and QBA are experts here. So, works out. I will be back shortly. Again, I'm going to walk the dog, maybe get a snack, so maybe 5-10 minutes. But thanks for hanging around, everybody, and I'll see you in a bit.